This is my front side cardigan. First, we are going to make the ribbing for the cardigan. We are working on the length way. If you want your cardigan bigger, please add more row at the ribbing part before you make half the burger shape. And then we are going to make the V-neck until the shoulder part. For the ribbing part, I'm using a 4mm crochet hook because I want the stitches small and tight. So foundation chain used for the height of the ribbing stitches. If you want it longer, please add more chains. And now I am switching the hook to 4.5mm and start make half double crochet stitches along the ribbing. Next, we are going to place a half double crochet into this stitches row. Thank you. For the next big loop there, we are not going to make half the bulk crochet into it. You have to skip it. Make sure you have 2 stitches between these 2 rows. This chain 2 doesn't come as a stitch, so I'm going to place a half double crochet into the very first stitch. And here, after you got 19 rows or 6.5 inches, we are going to decrease to make the V-neck. So if you want your cardigan longer, please add more rows before you make decrease. For row 20, just make a normal half double crochet into every stitch until you have two last stitches, and then we are going to decrease 2 stitches in 1 stitch. To make half double crochet decrease, yarn over, insert your hook into the loop, yarn over and pull through after loop. So now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and insert your hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through after loop. Now you have 5 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all those loops. And now you got a half double crochet decrease. For next row, we are going to chain 2, turn your work. So chain 2 doesn't count as a stitch. I'm going to place a half double crochet into a very first stitch until the end of the row. Like I said, this chain 2 doesn't count as a stitch, so we are not going to make decrease into this stitch. Keep decreasing until you reach your shoulder part. For the size of my shoulder part, it is 6.5 inches width. I recommend that when you decreasing until you get your shoulder size that you want, please stop decreasing and make a normal half double crochet row until you get the V-neck height that you want. After I got the size of the shoulder that I want, it is 6.5 inches width. So now I'm stop decreasing and make a normal half double crochet row for 2 rows. Next, We are going to make the back side of the cardigan. Just repeat the same thing as the front side. First, we are making the ribbing for 88 rows or 20 inches length, and then make half double crochet for 37 rows and start decreasing from row 38. So continue from row 37, chain 2, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. And then we are going to make decrease stitch, the same as the V-neck that we have made. So for this side, just turn your work and attach the yarn into a very first stitch and just keep repeating the same thing as the other side. Next, we are going to make the sleeves. First, making the ribbing around the wrist and then make half the burger shape and increase. To increase the slip for this part, I'm making 3 half double crochet stitches between these two rows. Make sure you don't skip these big loops like the last time that we did. You can see we have 3 half double crochet stitches between these two rows. Repeat this until the end of the row and then you will get your increasing sleeves. As you can see, it's a little bit expanded up there. So for the next row, chain 2, turn your work and make half the double crochet into every stitch until you have one last stitch, and we are going to make increase into that last stitch. Remember, chain 2 doesn't count as a stitch. If you want your sleeve look more puffy and bigger than this, please add more rows until you got your desired fit. This is the size that I want, so I'll stop increase from this row 2 and start making no more half the double crochet from row 3. Thank you. Keep repeating this until you got 29 rows or 10 inches length. It is the size after the ripping stitch until above my elbow. If you want longer sleeve, please add more rows. And now we are going to make increasing row again for making the upper arm part. Start from row 30 until row 47. It is 6 inches length. Remember, you only increasing at the end of the row. Next, after you got everything done, now we are going to attach the top edge of the back side and the front side together. After that, we are going to attach the sleeve. So I already done sewing two cherries on the middle part of the sleeve, one at the top and one more at the wrist part. It's more easier when you sew the cherries before you stitch the sleeve together. I will show you how I sew this to the cardigan after we have done everything. And now turn everything right side out and we are going to make the ribbing around the V-neckline. So we are going to make the ribbing stitch start from the right side of the cardigan until you reach the left side. Attach the yarn into the first stitch of the ribbing. Chain 7. So this is the side to fit the buttons. After you got 6 single crochet, we are going to slip stitch into the next stitch for 2 times. The ribbing stitch here is the same thing as the wrist ribbing, except that we have to slip stitch for connect them together. You can make the ribbing outside first and then take it to sew with the cardigan. Thank you. I am going to make 4 buttonholes. You must have the same number of the rows between these buttonholes. Guys, note this part. If this ribbing here looks stretching, please make a slip stitch decrease. For the second slip stitch, you don't have to make decrease. After you got 4 buttonholes, at the corner here, we just make a normal single crochet back loop only until the end of the row, and then we slip stitch for 2 times. Repeat this around the neckline until you reach your left side of the cardigan. Remember, if your neckline looks stretching, please don't forget to make slip stitch decrease. Thank you. And now your cherry cardigan is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and subscribe to my channel. Turn on notification bell so you will notify when I post the video. And see you in the next video. Bye bye.